Hello guys, welcome to my 10th class of Laplace Transform. We already discussed in my 9th class what's a Heaviside unit step function and then what are the results. I solved one problem also. I'm going to take some more problem based on that because I told in my video in 9th class, unit step function is a very one of the important topic in Laplace Transform they use further in our core subject. Yes? Now, well, in some cases, they are going to express the following figure in terms of unit step function and find out its Laplace transform. Now, they are not given any function. I will tell this is a function. Before that, we will please try to understand what they are given here. Express the following figure, what I written the figure, in terms of unit step function and find out its corresponding Laplace transform of that function. Are you clear? Now here they are not in the previous slide you already given the function. This type of thing is very very important in your signaling system and mechanical vibration etc. They have a figure, first you have to write it f of t and then you have to express that f of t in terms of unit step function or unit Heaviside unit step function. Now observe the figure is up 0 in the range 0 to 1. In 1 to 2 they have an increasing strengthening. And then once you reach 2, that must be stagnated. Stagnated at the value is 1. It's a constant. Therefore, now I'm going to take that function is f of t is 0 or say range 0 to t is nice between 0 to 1. Once you t is greater than 1 is increasing, we get a strike time. Therefore, what I'm going to take t minus 1. Why? Because you put t is equal to greater than 1 value. T is maybe a 1.5 like that. You put 1.5 minus 1, we get for t is 1.5, what's the value we get? 0.5, so maybe a 0.5. Yes? Now I have to put whatever the less than 2 value, then reach up to this. Suppose put t is equal to 2 here, what happened? 2 minus 1 or 2 minus 1 at most they reach what? 1. Therefore, in between 1 to 2, I am going to define a function what t minus 1 because t value greater than 1, once you subtract the greater than value, then we get an increasing line. Therefore, we have to take the function t minus 1 because of that, I consider t minus 1. Keep in mind, this is very, very important. Why I have taken t minus 1? Because my range is 1 to 2. Once you give higher value of t, we are expecting increasing value from 0 for y-axis, means f of t value 0.1, 0.2, 0.3. Therefore, I have taken a t minus 1. I have to subtract 1 because my mind over value is what actually? 1. Next is t is greater at minimum value t is 2. T is 2, what's the y? F of t value is 1. Even though greater than 2, what's the value is 1. Therefore, this is a function corresponding figure. After we get the function, first you have to express in terms of Heaviside unit step function. Means 0 into that I explained already. The range u of t minus what's the limit of a here? 0 minus u of t minus of a is 1. Okay? Plus, now in the second function t minus 1, what's the range? 1. U of t minus 1 minus u of t minus 2. Plus, last function, what's the last function? 1 into only 1 you have t minus 2. I explained already in the previous class. Once again I am explaining that. But is 0, therefore what happened? This function is 0. Only remaining these two. I to collect t minus 1 term, u of t minus 1 term and u of t minus 2 term because it's a polynomial. My t minus a and 1, these are the polynomial. What I am going to do? I am collecting t minus 1 into u of t minus 1 and also I am collecting what are the term here? U of t minus 2, there are two terms. One is minus of t minus 1 because I have to multiply t minus 1 here. We get minus of t minus 1 plus 1 into u of t minus 2. U of t minus 2. Now what we are expecting here? Now once you multiply by minus sign, now what we get t minus 1 into u of t minus 1, then multiplied by minus n, what we get actually 2 minus t we get 2, minus into minus plus 1 we get 2, into minus t into your t minus 2. But here what you have, t minus a is t minus 2. Here also we are expecting what? T minus 2. Then only we are going to use one of the formula, Laplace transform of f of t minus a into u of t minus a is what actually? E power of minus as into Laplace transform f of t or Laplace transform of f of t or capital F of s. Now, therefore, before going to apply Laplace transform, I took convert this also in the standard form. Why I took convert the standard form? Because then easy to solve the problem. Therefore, I am going to take minus sign outside, what we get t minus 2. Yeah, this is in the form of f of t minus a into u of t minus a. Therefore, I am going to apply Laplace transform on both sides. That implies Laplace transform of f of t must be equal to Laplace transform of first term, Laplace transform of t minus 1 into u of t minus 1 minus Laplace transform of t minus 2 into u of t minus 2. This is how we get this Laplace transform using linear property. LP means don't use LP, you write it fully linear property. Yes? Linear property. Okay? Yes. And then from this formula, what I written about? From this formula, what we get actually, Laplace transform of f of t is nothing but e power of minus a is 1 into Laplace transform of f of t other than minus 1 for this t minus e power of minus a is 2. Yes? 2 into s Laplace transform of other than minus 2 is 0. In the next step, we know that Laplace transform of t power of n, n is an integer. What is that? N factorial raised to the power of n plus 1. Here, power of t is integer. If I am going to talk to this formula, that implies Laplace transform of f of t is nothing but e power of minus s into 1 by n factorial by s square minus e power of minus 2s into 1 factorial by s square. Now, 1 factor is 1. If you want to take 1 by s square is a common factor. What's remaining? E power of minus s minus e power of minus 2s. This is a way to find out the Laplace transform of given function. Now, this is one of the important problems. This type of problem you are expecting in your core subject. Because in the core subject, you have a diagram. How to narrate f of t? It's a very, very important. Once you narrate f of t, how to express in terms of Heaviside unit step function. And then how to find out the corresponding Laplace transform. While finding Laplace transform after expressing a unit step function, this formula is very, very important. Now, after that, I'm going to take another last problem. This is one of it's a very good problem. That problem is actually express f of t must be equal to sin t. Okay? In the range 0 less than pi by 2, cos t in the range for t is greater than pi by 2. And also find its corresponding Laplace transform. First, you express in which form? Unit step function, Heaviside unit step function. F of t can be written as sin t into, just now explained, u of t minus 0 minus u of t minus pi by 2. This looks like a simple problem, but it's tricky. Plus cos t into, only one limit you have, u of t minus pi by 2. In the next step, this can be written as sin t. T can be written as t minus, sin t. Okay, I'll write it afterwards, t minus 0 minus sin t into u of t minus pi by 2 and then plus cos of t into u of t minus pi by 2. But here, even though they're having two terms, I'm not going to combine these two because they have a trigonometric function. F of t in terms of what actually? Trigonometric function. Whenever having trigonometric function, don't group it what I did here. I group here is a polynomial. Therefore, group what I did, I group u of t minus 2 term together and simplify that. Whenever having a trigonometric function, don't group it, because sine of pi by 2 minus theta is different, cos of pi by 2 plus theta is different. Therefore, don't group it. You express individually both sine and cos in terms of t minus pi by 2. Because you have a pi by 2, cos is changed to sine, sine is changed to cos. You have an even value pi or 2 pi like that is different. The pi by 2 is changed sine to cos, cos to sine. Even though they are having two terms of t minus pi by 2 for you, don't group it. What I did in the previous problem. In the previous problem is a polynomial, but they are having a trigonometric function. You know sine pi by 2 give rise sine of pi by 2 plus theta we get cos. Cos give rise sine after one to apply pi by 2. Therefore, what I am going to do here, this can be written as sine of t minus 0. There is nothing to happen, t minus 0. But here, instead of t, I want to what actually pi by 2. Therefore, now suppose I take what about the sine of t minus pi by 2, what we get actually sine of t minus pi by 2, what we get actually, try to understand that. I told already sine gives cos, cos gives sine. Now here we get minus cos t, we get it. Okay. And also cos of t minus pi by 2. Cos of t minus pi by 2. Now we get actually what we get actually here, sine t. Okay. We get what actually sine t. Now because sine of a minus t, what is sine of a minus t? Sine a cos b minus cos a sin b. Yes, this is 0 because sin pi by 2 is 0. Minus sin pi by 2 is 1, we get cos t. Similarly, cos of a minus b is nothing but cos a cos b and then plus sin a sin b. What is sin a? Sin t sin of pi by 2. Therefore, what is sin of pi by 2 is 1. What we get is sin t is t only. Are you clear? Therefore, now here I am going to express sin t in terms of what actually, please try to understand now what we are going to, if you want to know sin t, now I can express in terms of cos. Therefore, cos of t minus pi by 2 into what is u of t minus pi by 2. Are you clear? Cos of t minus pi by 2 get sin t. Therefore, instead of sin t, what I am going to write? Cos of t minus pi by 2. And then minus cos t is what? Sin of t minus pi by 2. But here you don't have minus sign. I'll write it minus. Minus of what? Sin of t minus pi by 2 into u of t minus pi by 2. Observe carefully here. Sin of t minus pi by 2 get minus cos t. Minus e to minus what we get? Plus cos t. Now we have to express in terms of standard result. Now we apply the Laplace transform. Once you apply the Laplace transform on both sides, yeah, Laplace transform first term, Laplace of second term, Laplace of the third term. We already solved so many problems. I am going to write directly Laplace of this. Now from this formula, what I written on the board, the formula you want to get e power of 0 into s into Laplace transform of other than 0 is sin t. Okay? Now here, e power of minus, what is my a is pi by 2 into s into Laplace transform of other than pi by 2 is cos t. And then minus e power of minus 2 or whatever pi by 2, a is pi by 2 into s, Laplace transform of other than minus pi by 2 is what? Sin t. Then you have to write, you know that what's the formula for Laplace transform sin t is what? 1 by I'm not going to write a formula because you are already familiar with that. A square plus a is 1. Minus e power of minus pi s by 2. Suppose you combine it together. Cos s by s square plus 1. And then minus e power of minus 2 pi by 2 pi. Minus pi s by 2 into 1 by s square plus 1. The final step for this. Suppose I have to write the final step here. What we get? 1 by a square plus 1 into what actually? Minus of, are you clear? E power of minus pi s by 2 into Laplace transform of sin t is 1 by a square plus 1 minus e power of minus pi s by 2 Laplace power cos t is s by a square plus 1. Now if you want to take LCM, whatever the common factor is, what? 1 by a square plus 1. If you want to take a common factor, remaining minus 1 e power of minus pi s by 2 minus s into e power of minus pi s by 2. Yeah. This is a thing. This again, we have to solve the problem. This is one of the tricky problem. You feel this is very easy, but keep in mind, whenever I express the given function in terms of Heaviside function, suppose having a trigonometry function, it carefully I have to write it. You can't group it. Suppose having more than one term having t minus pi, but you can't group it because sine is changed to cos, cos is changed to sine, especially for the angle pi by 2. Therefore, I explain why I try to express sin t in terms of cos of t minus pi by 2. Cos t can be written as we get actually minus cos t. Therefore, I take minus n because here having plus. Minus of what? Sine of t minus pi by 2 log t minus pi by 2. And then obtain the formula. We get very easily for this step. Now thank you very much for listening my talk. If we suppose you feel very comfortable my whatever videos, you please put a like button and also please subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.